Good afternoon, everybody. It is 12:30 on Friday, the 26th of February, the last Friday in February. As of next week, it'll be March and spring will be springing. So we do hope you're all feeling well and looking forward to easing out of lockdown gradually and everybody is staying safe. But it's been a great week. I'm Michelle from ADHD Unlocked, and I'm joined as ever by Stephanie, also from ADHD Unlocked. And this week we have been looking at careers and ADHD. So there are certain careers, for example, that are more suitable for the ADHD brain. And often when we have ADHD, we might find ourselves in the wrong career because we may have been pushed down a certain career by school or parents, expectations from society. Or we may find that we change career or we're suitable for many different careers, which we may want to try with ADHD throughout our lifetimes. But it's a bit difficult. These are big, big decisions, and work is often a problem for people with ADHD. So this is what we've been looking at this week as to how to choose the right career and how to go about finding out what's really going to light you up. So it's been really, really exciting and interesting, Steph, hasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, this is such a popular topic for ADHDers, right, for so many reasons, as you were saying. And following on from the week we did on communication of your ADHD at work, I think that did get a lot of people, a lot of our members maybe thinking, maybe this is not the right work environment for me. And so, yeah, this week we were talking about ADHD-friendly careers, so the type of situations that are going to play to our strengths, and also helping our members uncover their strengths, because it's difficult to narrow the options down. We all already have a problem with narrowing our focus, but something as big as a career, how do you narrow it down, right?
Yeah, and it is really, really difficult. And I have thought about so many careers and tried so many different things. And I'm now 48 and I've only just started doing what I think really lights me up and got to that stage where you feel that, yes, this is where I can really add value and use my strengths. But it's about using your strengths and finding your passion as well, isn't it? Because unless we've got that fire in our bellies, we tend to get bored and we tend to lose motivation, and then we will struggle to get tasks done.
Yeah, no, completely. And that's why it is so important. There's that saying, you know, make your passion your profession. And for ADHDers, it's certainly true. And having all those elements, again, Dr. Dodson's ICNOP, the interest, the challenge, novelty, urgency, passion, which is why I guess so many careers like ER, that you find a lot of doctors, lawyers, where kind of the stakes are high, you'll probably find quite a happy but very busy ADHDer. But what's difficult for us is kind of nailing it down or kind of just choosing one. But we talked this week, we had actually at our members meetup, a bit of a discussion around, well, do we even have to choose? And members were talking about all of this in the context of, I think someone was saying, like before the Industrial Revolution, that this kind of approach, having to just choose one career and stick with it, it's kind of outdated and not particularly helpful for us with our ADHD.
That's really, really interesting because we often find with ADHD, we're interested in a lot of things and that we can be good at several things. And actually maybe having a few things that we do, I can't even remember the word. Well done, Michelle. Obviously not, being a word finder is not going to be one of my careers.
But oh, hang on. There we go. This is why we love our community, multi-potentialite. Thank you.
That's the word. Thank you very much, Marie, in the chat for saying that. That was the word I was thinking. I was thinking, Michelle, why did you say that? It wasn't even on the tip of your tongue. But that's ADHD for you, but thank you so much. Multi-potentialite, and that is what a lot of us are. We have these multi-potentialite careers. So society, neurotypical muggle society, expects us to go down this one path, but why should we? You know, we are good at lots of things, but then we have to, for internormal society, earn money, pay the rent, pay the mortgage, buy food, pay the gas and electric bill. So, you know, we can't just like flit about. We do have to have some kind of plan so that we don't go financially bankrupt, etc.
Yeah, and that's, you know, when I see in coaching as well, there's that feeling us ADHDers have of just, yeah, they know they can do more. They just know they can do more, and they're just not fulfilling their potential, whether that's because they are in a career that isn't really for them, but they are doing because it provides security. And that's the issue for a lot of us, is that, you know, we don't embrace failure. We have a huge fear of failure. A lot of us already in our professions will have imposter syndrome. So the thought of actually pursuing your passion for an ADHDer, yeah, unless you're one of those really impulsive type of ADHDers, which there are a lot of, and a lot of entrepreneurs, right, are that type, it can be very difficult. We can get stuck.
Yeah. And I mean, I'm one of those impulsive people that gets that fire and goes for it, but I can understand that. But I have fallen down because of that, you know, in the past, and made choices with business partners which have gone wrong because I've been too impulsive and I haven't done my due diligence. So by all means, you know, harness that fire and that passion and that impulsivity, which makes you a good entrepreneur, but also bring other people on board to do your due diligence, so that you're bringing the right people on board with you, and that you're making the right choices, and that you haven't missed anything off, because sometimes we can be blinded by our passion, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't follow it. But that, I mean, there's so many things we could do. I mean, in terms of if you did want a career not to follow the entrepreneurial route, as you've said, Steph, emergency medicine or emergency situations, paramedics, you know, firefighters, that kind of thing, because we thrive on that kind of urgency. And I'm really good in an emergency. My brain just kind of works. I'm the first one on the scene if somebody collapses, and I'm directing everybody. And it's almost like I don't have any executive dysfunction in that sort of situation. Yeah. Which is brilliant. You find that the theatre is full of ADHDers. So I would argue, I'd love to do some random testing on theatrical people, you know, comedians, TV people, journalists, traders. Teaching's also, you know, big for ADHDers. But yeah, anything exciting where we can follow our passion and be involved with people's sales jobs as well. Yeah, we like to chase, we're kind of hunters. Really, really interesting.
Yeah, and there's a lot. And I guess, you know, we don't have to choose just the one, right? We don't have to. My daughter watched this Barbie episode where she was every single career under the sun, and then that was it. That's what she's going to do, apparently. So she's going to try everything out, which, you know, why not, right? You've only got one life. It can be difficult to narrow it down. So we actually had a member. This is the first time at ADHD Unlocked we had a member help us present our webinar this week on career choice, a kind of career expert, advisor, and he's actually trained to be an ADHD coach as well. So thank you, Ben, for coming and speaking to everyone on Monday. And it was a really popular and very effective session that he held with members, because we basically, a lot of our members walked away with their ADHD career statement, didn't they, Mish?
Yeah, which was absolutely brilliant. And Ben was absolutely wonderful. And it was really, really exciting. So Ben started off asking, what one thing could you talk about for 5 minutes without any preparation? So that just shows you what you're interested in, what you're passionate about, what you've already learned about, it's just like, well, yeah, there's several things that you could do. So that was a really exciting part of that exercise. But the statement was really, really interesting. So it's about using a couple of your main key strengths and your abilities and skills and where you want to add value. So, for example, you could say, I'm at my very best when I use my strength one with strength two, together with my ability two. So that's your unique skill. So where are you adding value and who are you helping with that? So, for example, here's one. This was from Ben himself. I am at my very best when I use my curiosity and appreciation of beauty together with my ability to notice things that others don't, to coach ADHDers around their career path, to help them to live rich and meaningful lives. So if you use that statement, and if you join the ADHD Unlocked community, we've got all this written down, the exercises that you went through for the whole webinar to really help to narrow down where you should be focusing if you're really struggling to find the right career for you. But that exercise was brilliant.
Oh yeah.
It made me realize I'm actually doing the right thing now, because my statement matched now what I'm doing, and that has not happened before in my life. So that was really exciting and affirming for me, but absolutely brilliant. And lots of our members put together career statements and are now kind of putting into practice some of the plans and goals to get those implemented.
Yeah, it was really effective. And then obviously at the members meetup, we all discussed maybe the things that could get in our way, and kind of the things that we need to take those next steps. And again, we've got all the topics we've covered to help us, you know, to get over a lot of these fears of failure, embracing failure, rejection sensitive dysphoria. So all the kind of tools that you need to kind of take the next step, we've got in Unlock 2. So we kind of referred our members, as we do with a lot of topics, back to other subjects, because it all, you know, they all play in together. We need a lot of things, us ADHDers, you know, and that's what ADHD Unlocked, I guess one of our biggest things that we do is to highlight these things and keep them front of mind, because you know what we're like, right? Out of sight, out of mind, we forget. So yeah, it's our members, they've really enjoyed this week. We'll have to revisit, I would say, again, I'm sure.
And just to illustrate our multi-potentialite qualities, one of our members has just put in the chat, and this is like a list of all of the things that ADHD is good at in terms of career, that she's worked previously in TV, news, so journalism is up to date, sales, teaching, cooking, which is also a career for ADHDers because it's really immediate and creative, property, and now writing. So this is like such a brilliant, brilliant list. And she's also done the sort of research and training as well of, you know, all of the career choices that would be good for an ADHDer, but she's done them all. So this is what we're like, but we shouldn't beat ourselves up for not following that traditional career path, because I did this for years. You know, I thought, oh, you know, people I went to school with, they've done this, they've become a doctor, they've become a lawyer, they've become an accountant, they've got their, you know, their career path all mapped out. And I've flitted about and done lots and lots of different things. And I used to beat myself up about that. And now I do not. And I just think how fortunate I am to have tried so many things, and the excitement of the new. And now I'm doing this because of my diagnosis 4 years ago, which I didn't know I had. And how wonderful that is in the book of my life to have done that. And actually, I would have been bored rigid probably had I done that more traditional career path. I don't know.
Yeah, no, definitely. As I say to a lot of my clients, actually, who sometimes, yeah, beat themselves up, like you're saying, nothing is wasted. Nothing is wasted when it comes to the different trying on the different kind of careers. Yeah, I remember actually having a go at my dad, because I think I wanted to be a dancer originally. I wanted to be a dancer or an actor. And there you go. Isn't this, Michelle, I don't think I've ever told you that. Have I ever told you that?
Like, why have you never told me this?
It never occurred to me. And that's so weird, given that you did musicals, but it never occurred to me. I never made that link. So ADHD is such an ADHD thing. But yeah, I actually did. I wanted to be a dancer and actor growing up. And my dad didn't think it was a good idea, because he's a GP, and he saw lots of dancers and actors out of work. So he wanted to push me down the professional path. Like you said, a lot of ADHDers, we find ourselves in careers if our families kind of push us. And coming from my dad's Indonesian, Asian family. So he was very much about me going to like law or medicine, which I did. And for a while there, you know, particularly when I got diagnosed, it was like, Dad, you should never have, you know, pushed me to do law. But the thing is, now I get to use it. I actually get to use it for things that actually count, that matter, that I'm passionate about, versus when I was in banking law. But so, you know, nothing, it's not wasted.
No. And all of the science stuff I did, because I was going to go and do medicine, but then I went to do theatre degree because I also wanted to be an actor. I'm still really interested in medicine, which is obviously helping with the ADHD work and all the research. I read all the papers. So it's not wasted. It's like you said, everything's come together for you and everything's come together for me. And you'll find that if you know, you just follow your path. And one of our members has just put that they work in indexing within publishing, but they would love to edit fiction. What do you need to do to put that into place? Because we do only get one life, and this isn't a dress rehearsal. We're not asking you to, you know, quit a really good job and not have any money coming in if you've got a family to support. We're not encouraging that. But if you're really passionate about something, what could you do to put these plans in place and actually get something concrete so that that you can live your best life and fulfill your potential? Because once you follow your passion, then you will be more likely to fulfill your potential. Your ADHD will be less of a challenge for you.
Yeah, that's spot on. And I guess using ADHD Unlocked as well is like a little platform to test out your new passion profession. So like what Ben's done, you know, and it was a great success. And it's also a really good practice to kind of play a bigger game, get out there. It's a bit, he was nervous, it's obviously. But again, it's the more you do it, the easier it becomes. And yeah, I think we were talking about maybe having a few other members periodically. We'll do these member spotlights. And again, so everyone can benefit from the expertise of the community, because it's huge.
Yeah, we've got some wonderful, wonderful people with some great skills and experience, really passionate, really inspirational, as Ben has been this week, really, really helpful. So, you know, do join us. Go to members.adhdunlocked.co.uk/shop to join us. But I just really just wanted to say that just follow your dreams. Do what lights you up. You only get one life. And what would you do if you knew you couldn't fail? What would you do if you knew you couldn't fail with your life? And I just wanted you to have a think about that question over the weekend. But next week, we've got a really, really interesting topic, and that is self-acceptance. Slightly different to self-esteem, although self-esteem comes into this, and self-love, but this is about accepting yourself as we really, really are. And I've done an awful lot of work on this myself over the last year, because I don't think I truly did accept myself until earlier last year. And it's really, really interesting topic. Got lots and lots and lots to share with you next week on accepting yourself, because a lot of ADHDers do not. And then the week after, so do join us, we've got a very, very controversial subject, and that is sex and ADHD and challenges and problems that we have with sex. So whether that's, you know, porn addiction, maybe getting distracted during sex. So it's a bit X-rated, but so that's the next 2 weeks. So do join us for the next 2 weeks. So yeah, really, really exciting. So I don't know if you've got anything else to add, Steph.
No, I think that question is a good one to ponder over the weekend, hopefully in the sun. It's a beautiful day, so if you haven't yet been out, get out there now, even if it's a quick walk, 10 minutes around the block, get outside.
Yeah, enjoy the sun and stay well. And it's nearly spring, so hang on in there and you're doing great. So thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next week. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.